Well, good morning, everyone. That's my favorite part. We're done. No. Welcome, boys and girls, teachers and staff, honored veterans, Sergeant Dan Clark, former U.S. Marine and Massachusetts State Trooper, Mr. Jason Cross, the Director of METCO, Ms. Michaela Saunders, the Director of Human Resources, and Dr. Linda Snow-Doxter, the school committee member, and friends of the Joshua Eaton community. Welcome to our 16th annual Veterans Day program. We proudly welcome all of you who are veterans who have joined us today for a special tribute to you and all veterans everywhere. I would like to draw your attention to this flag over here on the side, that is behind me, that belongs to our retired kindergarten teacher, Mrs. Gibbons. Her father-in-law got this flag in honor of his service during World War II. We thank Mrs. Gibbons for sharing this token of appreciation with us. Today, we are very fortunate to have two fifth grade students join us as MCs for today's assembly. I am very pleased to introduce Casey Vieira and Ryan Branson. I switched their name there, buddy.
Good morning. We will start our program today with the Pledge of Allegiance, our national anthem, and the playing of Taps.
The song called Taps is played at the graveside of a veteran who has died and is a very serious song. You will hear it played twice even though you can't see both musicians. Please do not clap when it is finished. We will have a moment of silence after the playing of Taps. Thank you to Brennan Memorial High School students Andrew Costello and Niall Singer for joining us.
Please stand up for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Gentlemen, veterans, imagine if you will that the year is 1814 and this nation is at war. You're on board a ship sailing toward the enemy fleet, that same enemy that just burnt your nation's capital to the ground. Your mission is to win the release of a prisoner of war, a respected physician, and your friend. You board the British flagship, and after intense negotiation, they agree to release your friend. However, you all remain captive because of the battle that is about to take place. On the morning of 13th September 1814, the British fleet began a bombardment against your homeland, the likes of which have never been seen before. Rocket after rocket, cannonball after cannonball, for 25 hours they pound on. But through the night, you're able to look toward the shore and you can still see the stars and stripes flying in the breeze. And in the morning, the bombardment ends and there is silence. And as you look toward the shore, you can see that the troops of Fort McHenry have raised an American flag that is so large and so grand that each of its 15 stars and stripes measure 2 feet across. A flag that is so magnificent, it cries out, "This is the United States of America, and we will never surrender." You are so moved, you write the following song. Your name, Francis Scott Key. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your national anthem.
Sunrise, stars, blue and pearl.
Thank you. You may now be seated. Veterans Day has a very special history. It first began as a way to always remember the end of World War I. That was back in the year 1918, over 90 years ago. The countries that have been fighting agreed to end the war on November 11, 1918. They signed the peace agreement at 11 o'clock a.m. on that day. Veterans Day started out being called Armistice Day because it was named after the peace agreement, which is called an armistice.
In 1945, veteran Raymond Weeks from Alabama had the idea to expand the celebration of Veterans Day to include all veterans, not just those who served in World War I. In 1954, President Eisenhower decided to change the name from Armistice Day to Veterans Day. Ever since then, we continue to celebrate Veterans Day each year on November 11th to remember that peace agreement that was signed on the 11th day of the 11th month at the 11th hour to end World War I. Mr. Weeks was determined the father of Veterans Day when he was honored in 1982 by President Ronald Reagan with the Presidential Citizenship Medal.
Joshua Eaton School is proud to recognize Veterans Day in a special way. We have songs and poems to celebrate the importance of veterans and also our country and the freedoms we have as United States citizens.
One of our Reading residents, Mr. Bill Brown, made this display of the flags that is kept at the superintendent of the school's office. We are proud to display the flags of the Army, the Navy, the Air Force, the Marines, the Coast Guard, and the Merchant Marines. This display represents the 7 major conflicts that Reading men and women have been involved in, many of whom are buried in Reading cemeteries. These conflicts are the Revolutionary War, the Civil War, the Spanish-American War, World War I, World War II, the Korean War, and the Vietnam War. Joshua Eaton served as a sergeant in the Revolutionary War.
We are so pleased to have so many of the veterans from our Joshua Eaton family here with us today. On behalf of all of the students and staff, I want to express our appreciation for your dedication to our country and our freedom. When I read your name, if you wish, you may stand or just wait, whichever you are comfortable with. Everyone in the audience, we are going to wait until we hear who the veteran is related to before we give them a respectful round of applause. We will start with Richard Ayer, Lieutenant Commander, Navy, Flight School during Vietnam, Maddie, Brendan, and Jack Egan's grandfather.
Jim Baxter, Staff Sergeant, Air Force, Vietnam, Willie Galtieri's grandfather. William Bennett, E4, Army, Vietnam, relative of Lily and Will Bennett. Bill Brown, Airman First Class, Air Force, Korean Action and Tripoli in Libya, community member, welcome. Francis Brown, Staff Sergeant, Air Force, Vietnam, Kaylin and Aaron Higgins' grandfather. Richard Brown, Major, Marine Corps, Vietnam era, Ashley, Morgan, and Kylie Brown's grandfather. Kevin Cashin, Petty Officer, 3rd Class, Navy Reserve, Enduring Freedom, Iraq Freedom, Sally and Emily Cashin's father. Rick Campbell, Specialist Army, Liam and Cole Campbell's father. Sorry. Dan Clark, Sergeant, Marine Corps, peacetime, 1984, our special guest and entertainer for today. Phil Corsi, third class petty officer, Navy, Vietnam era, Bridget Tyler and Ryan Branson's grandfather. Carmine DiGuglielmo, Sergeant, Army, World War II, grandfather of Nicole Nassis. John Des Moines, Sergeant, Army, World War II, Cuban Missile Crisis, Sophia Nazaro's grandfather. Welcome. Joe Donovan, SP5, Army, Vietnam, former Joshua Wheaton School Custodian. Welcome back. Alfred Dodfrey, Sergeant, Army Corps World War II community member. Welcome. Anthony Gallagher, Staff Sergeant, Marine Corps, Vietnam agent for the town of Reading. Thank you. Dean Gibbons, Corporal, Marines, Vietnam, husband of our retired kindergarten teacher, Marsha Gibbons. Welcome. Harold Goldstein, Sergeant, Army Engineer, Career, father of Mrs. Greco. Daniel F. Hayes, Airman, Second Class, Air Force, Jada Hayes' grandfather. Jim Jottle, Commander, Coast Guard and Navy Submarine, Vietnam, grandfather of Jack and Caroline Jottle. Robert Jenny, Commander, Navy, Cold War era, grandfather of Michael and Evan Jenny. Jack Johnson, PFC, Army, Germany, 1952 to 1954, Reading Community Veteran. Thank you. William Maloney, Captain, Army, Vietnam, Reading Community Veteran. Thank you. Jill Mayberry, Sergeant, Air Force, peacetime, 1976 to 1981, our school speech and language pathologist. Francis McGulty, Airman First Class, Air Force, Vietnam, friend of Mississano. Paul McGrath, Sergeant E5, U.S. Army, Vietnam, a Reading community member. Thank you. Philip Michelle, Commissary Men, Third Class, Navy Seabees, in Vietnam, grandfather of T.J. Michelle. Jim Murphy, Staff Sergeant, Air Force, K-9 Handler, Vietnam, Jack and Jane Murphy's grandfather. Christopher O'Brien, Captain, Air Force, Operations Southern Watch, father of Maeve and Mary Kate O'Brien. Kevin O'Sullivan, Sergeant, Air Force, Vietnam, uncle of Colin and Nicole O'Sullivan. Richard Peretti, U.S. Army Reserves, 1967 to 1973, grandfather of Caroline and Julia Higgins. Welcome. John Ratka, Commander Master Chief, U.S. Navy, 1972 to 1998, Haverhill Veterans. Robert Richards, Radio Man, Navy, World War II and Korea War, great uncle of Ellen Richards. Paul Ragazio, Airman First Class, Air National Guard, peacetime service, Anna and Grace Bowen's grandfather. Stephen B. Rock, Captain, U.S. Navy, priest at St. Agnes Church, and friend of Laura Desmondo. Frank Roscoe, Corporal, Army, Korean War, father of Liam and Cole Campbell. They had those results. Les Seidlinger, MR2 Navy, grandfather of Brendan Bolton. Guy Skelton, Lieutenant, Navy, Operation Desert Shield, Iraq Freedom, father of Samantha Skelton. James Smith Jr., SSG E6, Army Field Artillery, Korean and Vietnam Wars, great uncle of Ian Smith. Bessel Stone, Airman Second Class, Air Force, Lexi Bullock's great uncle, great grandfather. Thank you. Jack Terosin, Sergeant Marine Iraq, the godfather of Michael and Alicia Gabarino. John J. Watson, PFC, Army Air Corps, World War II, grandfather of Devin and River Watson. Lance Watson, Specialist E4, Army, Vietnam, grandfather of Travis and Taylor Brown. John McSherry, Sergeant, Army Field Artillery, grandfather of Brendan and Maureen Manning. Joe Massey, Air Force First Class, grandfather of Brian Massey. Is there any veterans that I did not announce that would like to be recognized at this time? So if we could please give a respectful round of applause for our veterans here today. At this time, I would like to introduce Mrs. McGevna, who will read the names of the men and women who are actively serving at our time at this time.
Following is a list of the men and women from our Josh Wheaton family who are actively serving our country. Gunnery Sergeant Dennis Cashin, Marine Corps, uncle of Sally and Emmy Cashin. Andrew Keene, Navy, cousin of Kiara Keene. Kevin Winslow, Air Force, uncle of Brendan Doan. Sergeant First Class James Skelton, Army, Special Forces, Green Beret, uncle of Samantha Skelton. Sergeant Jeff Pelledge, Army Rangers, uncle of Michael and Mateo Pelledge. Lieutenant Jared Pelledge, Army Reserves, uncle of Michael and Mateo Pelledge. one of my cousins. Sergeant Amy Kaspersick, Army, my cousin as well. Staff Sergeant Ryan O'Donnell, nephew of Mrs. Kylie. Brendan Reardon, Army, cousin of Mrs. Opolis. And finally, Jesse Gover, Navy, cousin of Mrs. Opolis.
Thank you, Mrs. McGevna. This year we have added a special tribute to our assembly. The students of Josh Wheaton have created a wall of honor. Mrs. Amendolia will tell us more about this.
Thanks, Casey. The index cards displayed on the board over here represent the family members of students and staff of Joshua Eaton. These men and women honored here are either actively serving, have completed their service, or have made the ultimate sacrifice for our country. We will have this on display for the students to take time to honor these men and women through Veterans Day.
Students at Joshua Eaton have tremendous respect for veterans and the services they have performed for our country. They are true American heroes. A student from each grade level will now join us to share their thank you to veterans. Please welcome Bridget Branson, GT Coyne, Ariana Olivari, Marie Mannon, Rihanna Sarone, and Kylie Brown.
My name is Bridget Branson. I'm in kindergarten. Thank you, veterans, for saving our world.
My name is JT Coyne. I'm in first grade. Thank you, veterans, for protecting our freedom and keeping us safe.
My name is Ariana. I'm in second grade. Thank you for your courage in the face of danger so we can enjoy our country safely. Some children in other countries are not as protected.
My name is Maureen, and I'm in third grade. Thank you so much for helping defend our country.
My name is Brianna, and I'm in fourth grade. Thank you, veterans, for fighting for our freedom. We go halfway around the world to make sure we stay safe, and we wanted to let you know how much we appreciate how much you sacrifice for our country.
My name is Kylie Brown, and I'm in fifth grade. America is one of the few places that gives us the right to make our own choices. That is because of the men and women either serving right now or who have served before. Thank you, veterans, for risking your lives for our freedom.
We proudly want Sarah Haas, Maddie Rupka, and Geo King to the podium to sing God Bless America, under the direction of Ms. Baum and our music teacher.
certainly have some talented students at Joshua Eaton. To display more talent, we have here our second grade who will recite a poem, Veterans Day.
All right, boys and girls, I don't know if your music teacher told you this, but Proud to be an American, or God Bless the USA, is one of my favorite songs of all time. I actually got to meet the young man who wrote this. His name was Lee Greenwood, a great country singer. He told me he wrote this a long time ago to bring all generations together, old and new. I'd like you to get on your feet and let's sing Proud to be an American. Here we go.
Can we the children and the wife? I thank my lucky stars to be
take that away.
Center of Inhale World, and our pennies help out veterans get jobs, get health care, and doctors go to school, and just have a good life after serving our country and being our heroes. And now I would like to introduce the director of the Northeast Outreach Center, Mr. John Redfield. 16 years. This is unbelievable. You, a number of times, had this Master Chief nearly to tears. Your tribute is just, it's phenomenal. And what many people don't realize in the community is the tribute that you have for our veterans every day, the help that you give us every day with your penny drive. Last year alone, we were able to house 500 homeless veteran families. Last month, 50 homeless veteran families. The number of homeless veteran families is increasing. We couldn't do the things that we do without your support. Ladies and gentlemen, veterans, fellow veterans, this is why we serve. Thank you all very much.
Thank you.
It's time to introduce our special guest of honor, Sergeant Dan Clark. Sergeant Clark is known to all of us as the Sand Trooper since his days with the Massachusetts State Police. He's now retired from the police force, but is still very active with his singing. This year is a special treat, Mrs. Mary Clark. Sergeant Clark's wife is also joining us. Welcome, Sergeant and Mrs. Clark.
You guys are fantastic, and you know, I know you've been sitting a long time. How about on your feet again, because I wanted you to sing this patriotic medley with me. You guys know all these songs. So, you guys ready? Shake it out.
Because Brendan, I don't know if he's explained this to you, he is definitely dressed up in a special, special garb. And music is very important to the military. Why? Especially during the time that he's representing, they use fifes, they use drums, they use bugles, because back then there was no such thing as iPhones, there was no such thing as radios, there was no such thing as communication. And all the communications between the troops were done by either fifes, drums, or bugles. And would you like to tell your classmates what you represent right here, Brendan?
I represent a colonial fifer.
And what did the colonial fifer do? He stood with the drums and the bugles, right? And they actually went with the flags and they actually marched into battle, right? And what was the fifers really, really doing? What were they doing? Were they telling people to march or were they inspiring people?
They were basically, they were giving all the commands.
That's exactly right. They were giving all the commands. And as you can see, he is dressed right up. Now you have the green, the vest today. Does that mean anything specific? Was that for this area right here?
That's actually because the group I march with is a 4-H group, so we wear green and white.
Well, that's outstanding. I want to thank you for doing what you do and representing people from a long time ago. Thank you, sir. Now, there are many, many people who go off to war. These days, you actually volunteer to be a part of the United States military. But not too long ago, our government says, you will come and you will serve. And it was called being drafted. And there was a young man who was very famous. His name was Elvis Presley. He was known as the king of rock and roll. And you know what? They came up to his door and they say, Elvis, you're gonna serve in the United States Army. Now, you might think that they would take the king of rock and roll and make him a captain or a major or something like that. Oh no, they made him a private. They started him right at the bottom, Private Elvis Presley. And then you might think that they would take the king of rock and roll and they would put him in some kind of special services to do shows and stuff like that for, nope, not at all. They actually put him in the artillery division. They sent him all the way over to a little place called Germany, and he served there in the tank corps. Now, the great Elvis Presley, he got out of his service, and he went back to making movies and singing. That's what he did. And he actually made a movie about his time when he served in the United States Army. Now, I am going to need a young man who likes to move, dance, and sing to help me be... I'm going to take Gronkowski right here. Is that Gronkowski? Come on up, Gronk. What's your name, sir?
Jack.
Jack. I'm Dan. Very nice to meet you. That's Mary. Now, have you ever seen on movies Elvis Presley move around? He does some crazy moving and stuff like that. Have you ever seen him do it? Okay. Well, what I'm going to do, you're going to do, Jack, what I do, okay? Just try to mimic me. Well, this is the way Elvis Presley used to dance and move. You know, he used to move around like this a lot. So, are you ready? Okay, we're going to have fun. Jack, this is Elvis.
Sure.
Jack, wait.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
There you go, Al Toon. Now, there are many, many great entertainers that travel all over the world to make our troops happy, give them a little slice of home. A long time ago, there were three sisters. And those three sisters were called the Andrew Sisters. They were very, very famous. They traveled all over the world. As a matter of fact, they were singing well up into their 80s. Now that they have passed away, and we like to do a tribute to these young ladies who gave so much happiness to the United States of America. The Andrew Sisters, and this is one of their most famous songs. That many of them had many, many different jobs, and many of them came from different branches. Now, each of the branches has their own hymn, their own song, which they're very, very proud of. Now, if you would like to help in my demonstration up here, what I'm going to ask you to do is I'm going to ask you to raise your hand high, and I'll call on you, and then you're going to call, come up. Now, when I pick you out, I'd like you to tell me what branch of service you would like to represent. What branch of service? Right here, right? Yes, sir, stand up nice and tall. What's your name, sir?
Ben.
Ben, very nice to meet you, Ben. I'm Dan. How are you doing, man? Okay, we have a whole bunch of branches of service. You can see the flags over there that we're making. What branch of service do you want to represent?
Air Force.
The United States Air Force. Ben, do you have any family members or anybody here from the Air Force? Okay, that's all right. Come on up, Ben. We're going to come right up here. Now, Ben, what you're going to do, if you look down, you're going to see USAF. That's the United States Air Force. You're going to put your toes in the line. Take your hands out of your pockets, okay, Ben? You're going to put a little curl in your hands right down there. Right along this, that's good. Right along the side of your trousers, like that. Head nice straight to the front, just like that. Lock your body up, Ben. Don't look around, no smile. Up, Ben. You also have to put your heels together, just like this. Ready? Watch. Heels together, feet at 45-degree angle, thumb on the seam of the trousers, head nice straight to the front, lock your body up. Now, Ben is now in the position of attention. No matter what kind of joke I tell him, he is not allowed to laugh. He's good. He's good. Okay, so Ben, every time I come up to you, sir, and I ask you who you represent real loud, you're going to say who?
Air Force.
Okay, Air Force, real loud. Okay, Ben, who do you represent?
Air Force.
All right, here we go. I'm going to come over this side. The young, right there, young, yes. Let me guess. I don't know who you're going to represent. Wait, wait, what's your name, young lady? Isabel. Now, Ben, who do you represent? Air Force, Isabel. Let me see. Let me guess who you want to represent. Isabel, who do you want to represent?
The Navy.
Absolutely. And you are wearing a very, very special shirt from the United States Naval Academy. That is where they, the highest of the best go to be United States Naval officers. Now, do you have a family member here who's from the Naval Academy? No, you just love the Navy. That's well. I like that, Isabel. So come on up. You're going to take a position right next to Ben, right there where it says Navy. You're going to put your toes on the line, Isabel, just like that. Heels at 45-degree angle, thumb along the seam of the trousers, right there. Head and eyes straight to the front. Isabel, lock your body up. Now, you're in the position of attention, too. Every time I come up to you, Isabel, you're going to say real loud, Navy, okay? Can you do that? Isabel, who do you represent?
Navy.
Outstanding. Ben?
Air Force.
Very, very good. Okay, we have two. We have two. I'm going to come all the way up. I'm going to go, Mr. the Red Sox. Stand up, sir. What is your name, sir? Jack. Okay. So we have your classmates, Ben, who represents? Oh, very good. And Isabel. Navy. And so, Jack, who do you want to represent?
Army.
Army. Outstanding, buddy. Come on. Do you have a family member who's here, Jack? Anybody in the Army? Is anybody here? Do you have a dad or a grandpa that's over here right now? Oh, okay. You're not sure if he's in the Army. That's okay. So you're going to come on over here. Grandpa, are you in the Army? No. Air Force? That's okay. All right. So Jack, he's in the Air Force, by the way, but that's cool. So anyway, so what you're going to do, Jack, put your toes on the line, heels together, feet are 45, scooch back just a little bit. Now see how my feet are, look down, Jack, right here. See, put your feet just like my feet. Yeah, there you go. We look like penguins, don't we? Yeah, very good. Okay, you're going to put your head and eyes straight to the front, Jack. Now you're in the position of attention. You're locking your body up. You are now representing my United States Army, okay? Every time I come up to you, Jack, real loud, you're going to say Army. Can you do that? Okay, Jack, who do you represent?
Army!
Wow! Isabel?
Navy!
Ben?
Air Force!
All right, okay. We got a couple more. I'm going to come all the way to the back to be fair. I'm going to come all the way to the back. The young man in the black Under Armour. Okay, now. Come on up, brother. You're wearing Under Armour. What's your name?
Ben.
Okay, we have another Ben. Ben represents? Isabel? Jack? Okay, Ben, who do you want to represent?
Merchant Marine.
Merchant Marine. See, this is an outstanding thing. Ben has chosen the Merchant Marines. Not many people realize that these men and women who serve on what we call cargo vessels, they actually do more than you would believe for the United States military. They were told in 1988, Congress actually made them veterans, and Ben is going to be representing my United States Merchant Marines. They like to be called Merchant Mariners. Now, if you put your toes in the line, sir, heels together, feet at 45-degree angle, just like my feet, just like there. Thumb along the seam of the trousers, head and eyes straight at the front, Ben. So every time I come up to you, sir, real loud, you're going to say you represent who?
Merchant Marine!
Outstanding. Jack?
Army!
Oh, it's up, Bill.
Navy!
And the other Ben.
Air Force.
Okay, very good. We have a couple more. I'm going to come all the way over to my little ones, all the way over here. Yes, sir, right in the plaid. Stand up nice and tall. Now, what's your name, young man?
JT.
Come on up, JT. Do you know what branch of service you want to represent, JT?
Air Force.
Oh, okay. Air Force is already taken by my young man, Ben, over there. Can you choose? Do you have a family member in the Air Force? You don't. That's okay. So, JT, you have a couple of other choices. Do you know? We have First Ben. Who do you represent?
Merchant Marines.
Jack.
Army.
Isabel. Ben. Okay, we have two more. Anybody you want to represent?
Rainforest.
What's that?
Rainforest.
Okay, what I want you to do is you're going to be my United States Marine. Can you be my Marine for me, JT? You can do that, can't you? Okay, come on up. JT's going to be my United States Marine. Okay, JT, what you're going to do is you're going to put your toes on the line, just like that. Heels together, just like me. See my feet, how my heels are together? Excellent. Toes at a 45-degree angle. You're going to put your thumb right along the seam of your trousers, right this. And JT, you're going to look straight ahead, head and eyes straight to the front. You lock your body up. This is in the position of attention, okay? Now, every time I come up to you, JT, real loud, you're going to say, Marines. Can you do that for me?
Marines!
Okay, now, I can feel that you want to say that other thing, that other motivational sound we make. With Marines, we say, Marines. Now, every time you say Marines, can you go, Marines. Can you do that for me, JT? Do it.
Marines.
Outstanding. Ben, who do you represent?
Air Force.
Isabel.
Navy.
Jack.
Army.
Oh, man, I'm going to give you some mic. Do it again, bro.
Army.
All right, Ben.
Marine.
All right, very good. Now, I have one left. How about this young lady right here? Stand up nice and tall. Yes. Who is left? Coast Guard. What's your name, young lady?
Maureen.
Do you have anyone here that represents the United States Coast Guard? Do you have any family member here? Okay. So that's excellent. Come on up, Maureen. Now, you know, probably know the Coast Guard not only protects you, but they also get sent to combat venues. Now, I'd like you to put your toes on the line, heels together, feet at a 45-degree angle, thumb along the seam of your trousers if you're wearing trousers, head and eyes straight to the front. Now, Maureen, you are now in the position of attention, okay? You're with everybody right here. JT, stop moving around. You're in attention, brother. We have to stand like this for hours on end. I got a major watching me, and if I don't do this right, he's going to yell at me. So, Maureen, every time I come up to you, real loud, you're going to say Coast Guard. Can you do that for me?
Coast Guard.
Ben.
Look at Maureen.
Jack. Isabel, Ben, and JT. Oh, outstanding. Okay, guys, what we're gonna do is we're gonna sing each one of your hymns. As the hymn comes up, I'm gonna step in front of you. You're gonna give a salute real loud. You're gonna say Merchant Marines. Then you'll drop your salute and real loud you'll say Coast Guard and you'll say Army, Navy. Okay, you guys understand? Now listen, before we go any further, I know I've taught many of you this before, but before they salute, why salute? Why do you see officers salute? Why do you see the Senior Master Chief salute? Why? Yes, sir.
Sign of respect.
Sign of respect. Outstanding, sir. It is a sign of respect. And there are certain special ways you're supposed to salute. Now I'm going to teach you. I know you guys already know that. Take your right hand out. You guys do this too. Take your right hand out and put all your fingers together, just like this. So they're not flying apart like separate flags, all together, just like that. Now, put your hand with your wrist, right? Pretend it's on your desk right in front of you, okay? Just so, now notice how straight your wrist is. Now, when you raise your arm to salute, you want to keep your hand and your wrist that straight. So you're going to slowly come up and shade your right eye in this fashion, just like this. Very, very good. Now, I'm going to come over and square my, JT, you're outstanding. Ben, very good. Isabel, Jack, very good. Everyone's outstanding here. Now, you guys can go ahead and put your salutes away, and you also, now everything in the military is done by command. You really can't do anything by yourself. You're told what to do, when to do it. Now, to give yourself a salute, the command is present arms. Present arms. But it really doesn't sound like that. When I give the command present arms, it sounds like this. Present! And then you snap up real fast and give me a salute. So we're going to try this, okay? Now remember, present, well, go ahead, put that down for me, Ben. Now, when I say present, you're thinking about what I'm going to do. And when I say arms, you're gonna snap it up. Okay, you guys ready? Here we go. Present! Snap! Very good, outstanding. Now they're gonna hold this position of present arms until I call the second command, which is to put their hands away. It's called order arms. And it sounds like, don't do anything, it sounds like this. Order! And then they're gonna snap and put it away, okay? So my platoon, you guys ready? Order! Present! Order!
Very good. Okay, once again, we're going to go through each of the hymns. They're going to salute, and they're going to real loud tell me who they represent. Ben, who do you represent?
Merchant Marine!
Coast Guard.
Coast Guard. Wait, what's your first name again?
Maureen.
Maureen.
Coast Guard.
Jack.
Army!
Wow, gotta love it. Isabel.
Navy.
Very good. Ben.
Air Force.
J.T.
Louis.
Oh. Okay, very good. You guys ready? And I want to thank my platoon up here. You guys ready? Raise hands! Toes up! Outstanding job. Ben, who do you represent?
I represent the Merchant Marine!
Outstanding, sir. Thank you very much for coming up. Very good. Maureen, who do you represent?
Coast Guard!
Very good, ma'am. Thank you very much for coming up. Wonderful scarf you have there, by the way. Jack. I don't know if I'm going to be able to hear you, Jack, so in your loudest, most, give me who you represent.
Army!
Outstanding. Thank you, sir. You are unbelievable. Isabel. Thank you very much for coming out, ma'am. And that is a very proud tradition, the United States Naval Academy, and it's a wonderful thing to aspire to. Isabel, who do you represent? Outstanding. Thank you, ma'am. Ben, you've been up here a long time, brother. Thank you very much. Who do you represent?
Air Force.
Okay, very good. Take a seat. Take it easy. JT. See, if I had to announce you, do you play football or anything like that, JT? You do? You play hockey. What position in hockey do you play? You do. You're a goalie. Wow. Outstanding. Now in goalie, please welcome, representing the Boston Bruins, JT. That's how I announce it. Okay, JT, who do you represent?
We.
Outstanding. Thank you, sir. Thank you. So before we leave you today, you've been very, very good. There's a young lady I would like to bring up. She happens to be my wife, but you know, in her other life, she's actually an opera singer. She sings these really, really, really high notes, actually can break some glass, but we won't do that today. She's gonna sing a song that actually came from the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, and I think she's going to hit the high note at the end. You know this very well. If you feel like singing along with the great America the Beautiful, you can. I'm gonna tell you the story about the young lady from Massachusetts who wrote it, and then Mary's gonna go right into singing. A long time ago, in 1893, a young lady from the Commonwealth of Massachusetts traveled this great country. She made it all the way out to the Rocky Mountains, to Pike's Peak, and she stood atop those mountains, and she looked back over this nation. She was so moved by this country's beauty, she wrote a poem. Now that poem was put to music. So beloved, many people actually think it should be our national anthem. Now if you go down to Cape Cod, Falmouth, Massachusetts, right in front of the public library, you can see a statue in this young lady's honor. Her name is Catherine Lee Bates from Massachusetts, and she is the one who wrote the one and only America the Beautiful. If you like singing along with Mary, please do so.
Yeah.
You guys are fantastic. I want you to know, on behalf of all the veterans who are here today, this does our heart so good to see you guys do this. And I don't know if any of you make it to the Patriots game, but on December 14th against the Miami Dolphins, I will be out on the 50-yard line singing our national anthem for the New England Patriots versus the Miami Dolphins. I don't know if they'll show it on TV, but if you're there, wave to me. God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Sergeant and Mrs. Clark. Can we have everyone just take a seat? We promise we'll wrap this up speedy fast.
Our country for our cherished freedom. Thank you for joining us here today.